It took me months to figure out that Lincoln had survived the massacre at Sammy's and was waging a war against Sal Marcano. The Bureau didn't have a file on Clay, and I wasn't aware of his military training because his service records were classified. Otherwise, I might have started to connect the dots after the death of Richie Doucette.
You really come through here. I'm impressed.
You also sound surprised.
I'll admit I carry some doubts about your level of commitment.
Marcano's a temporary problem. The Hollow, though, ain't going nowhere.
I just hope you and I stay aligned on what matters. I seen what power does, how it can change a man's focus.
See, that right there is the biggest problem we have. Every time you and I start discussing business, you start up about how the world works, about the trials and tribulation of colored folk. And you do it as if I have no idea, as if I just woke up this morning and found myself a man of color.
That's not what I'm doing.
When I was 7 years old, me and the boys from the orphanage weren't allowed in the shoe store. So we had to stand around out back and hand over an outline of our feet so the guy inside knew what size we were. When I was 10, there was this little white girl running around the neighborhood. We both crushed pretty hard on each other. But then her big brothers caught us holding hands in the park. They beat the fuck out of me, called her a nigger lover. They nearly killed me. There's a lot of things in this world I don't know, things I never experienced, and I got no problem admitting to that. But you need to stop talking to me as if being colored is one of them.
And yet you volunteered to serve a government that hates you, that sent you halfway around the world to kill our Vietnamese brothers and sisters.
I had my reasons.
Everyone has their reasons, Lincoln.
I'm here now, Cassandra. That's all that matters.
How all this shakes out in the end, that's what matters.
Remy Duval came from one of the most respected and wealthiest families in Louisiana. He invested in everything from oil wells to real estate, and he used his social status to get a radio program. Now, he used his radio show to preach about the collapse of polite society and the superiority of the Southern way of life. His family had been here for a couple of centuries, so his death was a shock. But even more shocking was the revelation that he was associated with the Southern Union, a group of wealthy racists who used their social positions to agitate against blacks.
Remy Duval, he was crucified and then burned alive. How do you justify that type of behavior?
Remy came from a long line of Southern cocksuckers, was always quick to trot out that war of Northern aggression and the South will rise again bullshit. Here's the thing about Remy. In 1965, he participated in the murder of four civil rights workers, one of whom they decapitated. They never found her head, so fuck him, he got what he deserved.
Sounds like your assessment of Remy Duval was spot on. Listen to this.
Look at what he's doing to us. Our neighborhood, our homes. I, for one, refuse to sit by and watch as some rubber-lipped nigger runs roughshod over everything we hold dear.
And what is it you hope to accomplish?
I will strangle that motherfucker, that's what I'll accomplish! I apologize. Shouldn't use that kind of language.
He is egging you on, Remy. You are much too important to be caught up in all of this. Is the situation unfortunate? Of course it is. But nothing he is doing changes anything. Let Sal's men handle it.
Sal's men? Olivia, the people of this neighborhood expect me to protect them, not some greased up wop assholes. No. I need to respond to this. I need to send a message to those niggas and the guineas. But here in Frisco Fields, we take care of our own.
This is a mistake, Remy. You could jeopardize everything we have been working toward.
Our very way of life is at stake, and you think I give a goddamn about some casino? Sometimes I think you've forgotten your station in life, Olivia.
A minute or so later, Olivia called Sal. Told him Remy's Southern Union pals were out looking for you. If you head back up there, I'm sure it won't be long before you run into some of them. Get them to tell you which hole Remy's hiding in.
Yeah, once I'm done with that prick, Olivia's next. But getting to someone like her ain't gonna be easy. Between Marcano's men and all those rich white assholes she runs around with, they'll spot me coming a mile away. I need you to look at our options. Come up with a plan.
Okay, I'm gonna look at our options and come up with a plan.
What's wrong with you, man?
Personal hygiene is very important.
See how they came waltzing in, dicked out in their fancy white robes?
My daddy used to say the only thing worse than a nigga is a rich white man putting on airs.
Ain't that the goddamn truth?
Those assholes will come on out for Mr. Duvall's speech. Might even hoot and holler and wave their arms around, but me and you both know when it's time for us to get our hands dirty, time for us to collect ourselves some nigger scalps, anyone wearing one of them fucking robes, they vanish real quick.
Someday I wouldn't mind doing to them what we're planning on doing to those niggers. Okay, that didn't sound right.
Could have swore I heard something.
This very minute, slitting the throats of white men and women right now. I know what some of y'all are thinking. Fuck this city, Remy.
Fuck.
Fuck the thieves and the racketeers. Fuck the politicians who take our vote. Don't care two shits about the common man.
Fuck 'em, Remy.
Fuck 'em, Remy.
Fuck the niggas. Fuck those unwashed, debased, big-lipped, bug-eyed savages who grow fatter and lazier off everything the white man has ever made. Fuck the wasps who are twice as bad, thinking they can walk upright with the white folks. No, I've seen them, y'all. I have seen these invaders slouching through our city. Hands out for handouts, stealing everything else. You know what it makes me want to do? It makes me want to let them burn it all to the goddamn ground again. That's right. You know, we could do that. We could just give up. Let it go. Hell, give it to them even. We could. But I won't. No, no, I love this town. I love this country a little too damn much to give up. My great-great-great-grandfather didn't, and I sure as hell won't. Will you? Hell no. Hell no. Now, if the wops and the hippies and the communists and the fucking niggas want to take this city, then they're going to have to fight us for it. You tell me. After us, huh? Well, I say we respond in kind.
That's why tonight, we're going down to Delray Holla. Every fucking one of us.
Yeah.
And we're gonna show them what happens when you go to war with true Americans. And hell, after that, we gonna see who wants to fuck with the white man. Burn it down! Burn it down!
Burn it down!
Some bitch, grenade! Some bitch got me pinned! I got something for his ass!
Fields is one of the city's most prominent citizens, Remy Duval, was savagely murdered. Witnesses report he was bound to a cross and set on fire. Let's see if we can get a statement from the police. Chief Wilson, you care to make a comment?
It's those goddamn niggas. Every last one of them needs to be rounded up and shot.
That's quite a statement, Chief.
You need to wipe the shit out of your eyes, son. Take a look around. There's a goddamn war going on!
So, since we're all friendly now, been thinking about the story you told me. How Doucette kidnapped and murdered your sister?
Is that right?
Lived around here most of my life, and one thing I know is if something like that was happening, everyone in the Hollow would be talking about it, warning each other.
Are you calling me a liar?
Nah. You might not be telling me the truth, but that don't mean you lying. Just saying, we should be on the level with each other from now on.
It wasn't my sister that was killed. It was my daughter, Caroline. Dixie Mafia was running a still in the creek nearby grandmother's place. She was a religious woman, didn't believe in drinking, so she tore it apart.
And they came looking for blood.
There were five or six of them. Surrounded the house and... I tried to get Caroline behind the dresser, but I didn't have time. They shot my grandmother out on the porch. I took one to the stomach and was left to die. If I had a gun, my daughter would still be alive. I guarantee you that.
Shit. Listen, Cassandra.
Ain't anybody else protecting us, so we gotta protect ourselves. It's as simple as that.
I still don't understand why Olivia Marcano was involved in any of this. By all accounts, she had two or three times the money that Sal Marcano had.
Money didn't mean shit to her. From what I was able to piece together, she hired someone to kill Lucho. Wanted to run things herself. Bottom line, I think she got off on all that mob bullshit.
We're fucked, Olivia. You understand? That fucking shit-stained Duval didn't name us in the will. Now everything's going to his goddamn nephew?
Have you actually reviewed the will?
I read the part that said all the land I'm building my casino on is now going to Steven motherfucking DeGamo. I read that part.
6 months ago, Remy revised the will, but he never executed it.
What the hell are you talking about?
In order for the will to be valid, it needs to be signed.
Well, goddammit, woman, I know that. What does it mean for us?
It means I have grounds to contest. Remy and I were business partners in several ventures, and one of my holding companies lists the land as an ancillary asset.
Sounds like a lawyer's wet dream. What's something like that gonna run me?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Nearly every cent I got is tied up in that goddamn casino. I can't afford a big legal fight. There's got to be another way out of this mess.
Steven is coming to town for the funeral. I could arrange a meeting. Offer him a percentage of the casino's profits if he signs over the land.
Yeah. Yeah, that could work. And then once he signs, we take care of him. All right, set it up. But my patience is at its goddamn end. Do you understand, Olivia? I'm tired of this bullshit.
Have a little faith, Sal.
Now, Mr. Clay entered the country club disguised as a waiter.
Everyone in attendance was a rich asshole or part of the Southern Union, so getting Lincoln in there was easy. You put a black man in a uniform and he's damn near invisible. Hell, I drove in through the front gate and dropped him off. No one even gave us a second look.
No. Surely, his uniform wasn't enough to get him past Mrs. McConnell's personal security detail.
I mixed up a vial of fast-acting LSD. You know, same basic formula that we use as part of MKUltra. And I gave it to Lincoln. He used a syringe to put a couple of drops into every drink he served. Within a couple of minutes, anyone who drank that concoction was whacked out of their goddamn mind.
Fuck me.
What? What happened?
I never learned how to tie a bow tie.
You sure you're up for this?
Shit, I'll get in there and dose the guards with his military-grade LSD and get to Olivia.
Don't let those pricks goad you into anything. Remember, you won't be able to take any weapons with you. How's it going, buddy?
Follow the driveway up to the left.
You've got the case, the syringe is in there. And remember, the drug acts fast. It'll fuck up whoever gets a dose real quick.
Good. No sense in giving anyone time to figure out what's happening.
Let me get a look at you. If they kill you, at least they'll have something nice to bury you in.
Fuck you.
You see everybody else got here on time.
Them crackers put their hands all over everybody else.
Lazy nigga. That's their job.
Had me out there. Fucking asked me where I got my car. Where I'm from.
You best get in that uniform or get out of my goddamn kitchen, Claudia. Follow me. Get a rag on that counter. Looking like a goddamn rat's nest. Miss Olivia's gonna be out soon. She gonna say some words for old Mr. Remy. Can't stand a lazy nigga. Nothing low on the face of God's earth. Get one of those out there to them folks and serve them their drinks. And don't go talking to any of them, you hear? You ain't get them folks their drinks now. Stop right there. Hold on.
You ain't been paid to stand around, boy. Go serve them poor folks.
Drink up, motherfuckers.
So do they have a suspect?
Not a one. Old Earl set to send some of his boys out to the holler, rattle some of them monkeys' cages.
I don't see it being one of the coloreds.
Fucking apes was never too smart, but you don't watch them. They get vicious real quick.
First, I'd like to personally thank y'all for coming to see our dear friend Remy Duval off. I know with all of the violence that has reached its way into our community, it might have felt safer just to stay at home or even leave town. But you did what Remy would have done. You held your head high and you didn't run away. It's not exaggerating to say that Remy was a brave man. But his bravery is not what I'll miss most about him. What I'll miss most about Remy Duval is that he gave this city... No, he gave us a voice. The man who murdered Remy robbed this city of someone who honored its history. Not only that, Remy respected our shared Christian heritage, which extends all the way back to Europe. Remy was a dear, dear friend of mine. A dear friend to all of us. In the coming days and weeks, let's honor his memory by taking back our city, by preserving the way of life we hold dear. To Remy.
To Remy!
We ain't kin, so fuck off.
Every time I see one of them hippies, I punch him right in the mouth.
Goddamn right.
We find the shine who killed Remy. He's gonna wish he was dead.
Reginald, please
get over
voice
here
down
with that bottle, what? Man.
Oh, he's probably one of the good ones.
Yes, I'll miss him too.
Harmonious clause lets the FHA sidestep integration. Technically, the landlord can point at that and tell your colored friends to be on. Frankly, the case is a loser, a non-starter. So, of course, I'll take it.
Right.
I've never actually seen the nephew either.
Hey, I hear there's some
bring
money.
That bottle over here.
Maybe.
Spill it. What do you know?
Well, let's just say there was a lot more
well,
to the Duval fortune when his daddy
died. And I shouldn't have
died
to beg for it, is all.
Oh, come on now.
She says I don't talk to her enough. Like I can get a word in edgewise.
Yeah. She hands me these brochures. Mexico, Brazil,
yes,
Honduras.
I'll miss him,
I
too.
I put them right in the trash.
I mean, every said, last goddamn dime is gone.
Yeah, he's the bottle.
What am I going to tell the Autumn Brothers?
We'll remind them to maintain white pride, brother. So, because right now, it's the only thing the Southern Union has to its name.
You can smoke over here.
You see how Clarence is behaving? Looks like he's got a touch of whatever's going around out there.
Ask me, it couldn't have happened to a nicer fella.
Serves him right. Nigga this, nigga that. It's every other word that comes out of his mouth. Bad enough hearing it from all these white folks, don't need to get it from one of our own.
Maybe after this, he'll rethink how he runs things around here.
That'll be the damn day. Before going out there, something's gotten into those folks. Something bad.
I don't care what Clarence says, I'm staying in here. Those people have gone crazy.
Finna cut that crackle.
What was I saying now?
I just... I wish I could show you. It's all connected. You see? We, you...
Holy shit.
See you at Sunday Mass.
Goddamn Donovan.
Yes.
Bloody mind.
I see him. I see Remy.
Something is wrong.
Wait.
Get me out of here now.
Yes, ma'am.
I want additional men placed on the front door and around back. No one's allowed in or out without my say-so.
Should I say something to the guests?
Such as? You saw them. They've all come down with some kind.
That for Ms. Marcano?
Yeah. I mean, yes, sir.
Go on through.
Put it on the bar. Has DeGamo signed yet?
No, ma'am. And they've been beating on him pretty hard.
Take one of his hands, see if that changes his mind. We need to get away from here before whatever is happening downstairs gets worse. I think our Negro friend here is a little dim. Won't someone get him out of here?
That bastard. Who you think you're fucking with?
This is Marcano.
I got no move here. Fuck!
Kill him!
Cover my ass! Go! Lost another one!
Precisely. The first time I saw Lucio, he looked so handsome. Dashing, even. He wore the finest suits, drove the best cars. There was always something terribly romantic about all of this.
There ain't nothing romantic about robbing and killing people.
Maybe not. But it certainly was exciting.
Where's DeGamo?
DeGamo. They have me out in a building. Down by the water. Thought you were gonna kill me.
You ain't worth the trouble.
Nah, I ain't asking you a second time, boy.
The sign over that land? Hmm?
I swear to Christ, I will bust every fucking bone in your body. You hear me? Hmm?
I'm not signing a damn thing.
That cat must have took off.
Maybe you can find him. I say we try that area.
Lead the way.
Look! Oh, your top! Oh.
Got you all to my spot.
Now it's my turn.
Only what's left you to my dolls!
Come on, you son.
Christ, my hand is ruined.
Gamo, I'm gonna get you out of here, but we need to move. Marcano's probably sending more men.
Yeah. Okay.
If they brought me here in my own car, I think it's still near.
Yeah. Oh, God.
He's dead.
Christ, my hand is ruined! I barely even knew Remy!
Suspicious individual in vehicle. Officers
investigating. Get me up here! Just let me out here! Oh, you see him? Her hair.
There he is! Let's go! Guys on the side.
You're gonna kill us before they do.
We're gonna die right here on this road.
Burke says you can help me keep the cops mellow. That's a bad idea.
Let me the fuck out!
How long you think you'll last out there?
You're worse than those lunatics back at the country club.
Where was I? How long you think you'll last out there? Marcano ain't gonna rest till he finds you.
He broke my hand! Shit! I just wanna go home.
I know. Listen, I got a friend. He's gonna keep an eye on you for a while when you're safe. At least till things calm down.
Okay. Thank you. And you saved my life.
No mention.
Lincoln left him with me, and I got him the hell out of there.
And you still know DeGarmo's whereabouts?
Like I'd tell any of you assholes.
Good morning, Miss Marcano. I'm here with your breakfast. Let's freshen this room up. Get some of that sunlight in here. That's better.
Are you telling me Lincoln Clay did not murder Olivia Marcano?
He didn't kill women unless he had no other choice.
I find that very hard to believe.
Back in 67, we were in a bar in Saigon, and this gook bitch comes strolling in. Skirt barely covering her ass, and she starts offering everybody blowjobs.
Gee, I want sucky fucky. Hmm? Gee, I want boom boom.
Then she pulls out a grenade and she kills three guys. A couple Marines in the bar want to cut that bitch's head off, but Lincoln stops them. Keeps them off of her until the MPs show up. If he wasn't going to kill that slag, he sure as fuck wasn't going to kill Olivia Marcano.
Who'd you send?
Oh, I did it myself. Ear to ear, just like you wanted.
Any sign of DeGarmo?
Gone.
I mean, I look everywhere. It's like he never even fucking existed.
Well, this is a goddamn mess if ever I saw one. Between Duval's will and his fucking Lincoln Clay, it seems this shit's never gonna end.
At least we don't have to cut Duval in on the action anymore.
You trying to be funny? DeGarmo's lawyer's gonna keep this tied up in court for years. I ain't got that kind of time, you understand? Or money.
There's got to be someone we can get to force them to make this right.
It takes a lot of pull. Pull we ain't got.
Could always call Leo Galante and ask him.
Fuck him. The whole reason I'm building this goddamn casino is to get out from under them worthless fucks. Not bringing the commission. They're gonna want to cut everything. God damn it. Go on, get the hell out of here. I gotta make this call. Leo! Yeah, Sal, how the fuck are you? Listen, I got something I need to discuss.
I tried
trying to reconcile the part of me that helped Lincoln with the part of me that vowed to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ. But I can't. You know what I remember? I remember watching the news and learning they had gunned down Dr. King. I remember watching people lash out, riot, because that's all they had left. All the while, Lincoln's in the other room, barely clinging to life. Maybe that's why I did what I did.
Welcome to the party, lad. Now, if only we had a couple of pints.
I put Olivia Marcano in the hospital, but I'll be surprised if she makes it through the night. Sal's gonna know that he's lost Frisco Fields, that we've taken over his drug operations there and shut down his fucking greengrocer. He won't let that stand.
Took care of securing this part of the city for you. The boys are looking forward to making their cells at home as soon as possible.
Shit, son, I could have secured those rockets as well as anyone, probably better. You chose me to run the day-to-day for the last piece of the city, and I expect to be running it here as well.
This is all news to me, but if you still want to send it my way, I'll take it.
Gotta say, this action's perfect for Cassandra.
Look at you staying true to the holler. Impact of this kind of change is gonna be felt across the city.
Better luck next time, I guess.
Are we done here? I got a whore named Sadie and a bottle of Shane waiting.
Time to get back at it. Let's clear out.
Christ. Ain't you just the goddamn prince of perfect fucking timing?
You okay?
What could possibly make you think I'm not?
You got them cars I asked for?
Yeah, I got them.
Good. Because now we need boats.
The fuck does the IRA want with boats?
The IRA comes knocking at your door, you don't ask questions, you just do it. Otherwise, you'll wind up with your picker jammed down your own throat. Which, from what I hear, ain't as much fun as it sounds.
Besides, it ain't like you're not getting a healthy piece of the action.
Dude, this shit ain't adding up. And it makes me nervous. I don't like being nervous.
We're partners, lassie, but you don't run everything in me fucking life. I got concerns that stretch outside of what we're doing.
You talking about Nikki? Is this IRA shit about to blow back on her?
No, that will not happen.
Just so we're clear, if Nikki gets caught in the crossfire of your shitty life choices, puking in the fucking sink will be like your sweet 16 compared to what I'll do to you.
Oh, lad, your sweet words are getting me all hard now. But you have my word. No harm will come to Nikki on account of any of this.
So it's both now.
Aye.
Yeah, I'm of two minds when it comes to Lincoln's legacy. On the one hand, he was a brutal criminal who killed God knows how many people. A new breed of mobster, a prototype for criminals to come. Someone like that doesn't deserve the position history has afforded him. He should be forgotten, erased. But I also understand that Lincoln had a significant impact on the Italian mob in this city. He did what the Bureau wouldn't or couldn't do. He finished them.
I got a name for your judge. Cornelius Holden. He just made a call to Lou.
I get worked up. I barely avoided that.
Cornelius is 60. The dipshits of this state first elected him to the Fifth Circuit in 1951. There's something else you should know. Those two men are Lamont Harris and Trey McCall. They were killed by a man named Hollis Dupree.
Yeah, I heard he gunned them down when they showed up to his house asking for help.
Hollis claims he was in self-defense, said he thought they were there to kill him. Cornelius is the judge that's presiding over the trial.
So killing him might kick up a lot of noise.
Cornelius is an entitled southern asshole. Killing him is going to do a lot more than kick up some noise. Hopefully, it'll send a message that is long past the time that those cocksuckers went extinct. That's the car down there that Lou was talking about.
That thing armored?
I pulled the work order for it. It's a complete custom job. Tough as hell. It'll take a pounding, but it won't be impossible. Cornelius is scheduled to leave any time now, so this is your window.
You follow a set route?
Not since the trial started, but he still makes a stop or two on the way home. So, you can either hit him then, or go after him when he's driving around.
All right.
And watch out for the cops.
Thank you. What now, Your Honor?
Home? What time is it? Oh, no. Miss is still awake and I'm not in the mood for her theories. Keep driving. Well, hot damn.
To be an American.
After that, I'm the about ready. What are you waiting for? Go! Go!
Reports of a large Negro male in the French ward. Please investigate. Be advised, suspect now in a vehicle.
That should be the last of it.
Is that a fact?
If it moves on wheels or floats on water, I brought it in. Now what the hell is this all really about?
As a father, you got one fucking job. Keep your kid above ground. And I failed miserably.
Danny, he understood the risks.
No. Danny did whatever I asked him. He never questioned a damn thing. He trusted me. Nikki wants out. Away from me, away from this goddamn city. And I'm made to help her. But that takes money.
How's the IRA factor into that?
They don't. I've been selling everything to some fellas I know out in the East Coast.
Why the fuck didn't you just tell me that in the first place?
I didn't want Nikki finding out. I was trying to do one thing right by her. I was still able.
While you're still able?
I'm dying, goddammit. Is that bloody clear enough for you?
Burke, I don't know.
It's one thing to be struck down by a bullet. Another thing altogether to slowly be eaten up from the inside out. I've got liver cancer. Doctors say another 6 months, eight if I'm lucky. And I ain't ever had much luck.
Jesus.
Stays between us, you hear? Not a word about this to Nikki.
She deserves to know. What you asking me to do?
I'm asking you to let her keep believing her old daddy ain't a good man. He never has been, and he never will be. There's no lie in that. And once they've gone to God, all the money will go to her.
Lou Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden, is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now it's to keep holding him one goddamn pistol after that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now listen here. I know a guy, a state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. Get him laid. All that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down to shit or we're fucked. All of us.
Well, I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou, get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacobs is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou and was basically the Santa Claus of the French ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
Thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
Ready to go when you are.
Assume you already mapped out where the riverboat's gonna go.
Lou's pretty fastidious about that kind of thing. Always follows the same path when he goes cruising through the bayou. Doesn't want anything to happen to his beloved Delphine.
gonna be the least of his problems. You recon the area?
There's an old coal dumper that they have to sail past. I've already got it rigged to blow. You just need to connect the primer cord to each block and then set it off. Detonator's down by your feet.
All right.
Isolate and kill. Lincoln Clay's specialty. What's wrong? Yeah, it's the boat thing, isn't it?
Not saying it is, not saying it ain't.
You need to get over it. You were on, what, 40, 45 PBRs in country?
52. That's not the point. You don't know what it's like to get onto a boat knowing full well the damn thing's gonna sink? Gets old, man.
Look, you blow the coal dumper. Boom. It hits the boat. Then you jump on board and kill Lou and those other assholes. 50-50, you don't even get wet.
50-50?
40-60, but still. .30-70 at the worst.
Upstairs. You'll fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
Look, I asked him.
please.
It's gonna blow! Ah! Ah! I was ready to die, but I ain't. Help an old lady out of here!
Your time is up, motherfucker. Time to die, quick.
Thank you. far enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step and he gets it.
You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on!
Money? You can have it. All of it. Just don't kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
Jacobs was killed this evening in a fiery explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
I understand you supplied the heroin Georgia was selling.
Si, certo.
Never wanted that in my city. Shit like that fucks with people's heads. Makes them crazy. Stupid. Brings down too much heat. Bourbon?
No, I do not drink.
Georgia tell you why I wanted to meet?
He said the nigger killed your brother. That you wish to disguise a deal between the two of us?
They found Lou tied to a statue over in the French ward. He was gutted like a goddamn catfish.
I apologize for your loss.
Lou fucked up. It's his own damn fault. Look here. I'm building a casino across the lake. I had it all set up to get gambling legalized. Now it's all a goddamn mess.
You want my money.
We need to get to the governor, and it ain't gonna be cheap.
I want to hear you say it.
Say what?
That you want my money. Say those words, please.
I want your money.
This is good. I will bring you the money, and in exchange, you will let me sell heroin in your city. And you will not interfere in any way.
Sure. Whatever you want.
That's not the only...
You also wish me to kill the nigger. I will do that for you as well. I enjoy killing the niggers.
Jesus Christ. That's where Sammy's used to be. No one wanted to live there, so they paved it over. Every now and then, something knocks the hell out of this country. Rattles it so hard, isn't much left but the foundation. And as painful as it is, we hope that this time, things are gonna be different. And that when it's time to rebuild, we won't just repeat what we've done in the past. And that maybe justice and peace will finally prevail. Justice and peace are hard, ain't they? Sometimes too hard. So we take the easy way.
Come on in. We just having a friendly conversation.
Come on in. This city's gonna learn that their dear old Uncle Lou didn't die out there in the swamps when his riverboat sank. And with Lou dead, Sal's gonna be scrambling to figure out his next move. Meanwhile, we're gonna take control of the plowhouse, the cistern, and all the drinking and fucking in the French Ward.
The district's locked down just as you asked. Me and my boys are just waiting for your word to make ourselves comfortable.
Maybe I missed a call or something, but I didn't even know you were working that part of the city.
There's more of this city under my control than not. So you can call your cracker cleanup crew all you like. But in the end, it ought to come right back here.
This one's all you, Burke.
You're a goddamn genius, lad.
I'm gonna call this if no one else will.
All right, so if we done, I'm gonna go.
All right, that's it. We're done for now.
Eventually, I got a witness to come forward with information that implicated someone other than Sammy Robinson. A woman who lived near Robinson's place saw Sal Marcano and his son Georgie leaving the bar the night of the killings. I tried to bring Sal in for questioning, but all my efforts were blocked by a Judge Holden, who we now know was on the take.
So? So you can cross another name off your list.
He suffer?
Not really big on prolonging the inevitable. Now, if you wanted this handled like Greco, I could have brought him back here.
Greco was a whole other thing. Call it heat at a moment.
But your friend must have been something else if it took all these guys to bring him down.
A couple of those cocksuckers sold him out. Fucked him when he went to them looking for help.
And they all ended up down here.
Commission gives Sal extra leeway on how he runs things. In exchange, he takes who they send him. Makes him part of his organization. I guess wherever you find assholes, you find pieces of shit.
Present company excluded.
Present company excluded.
No matter what you do, it's never right for you. And you keep on running.
Sounds like all hell's breaking loose.
Suspicious individual on foot. Officers investigating. On scene, officers engaging. Respond with caution.
Eat shit.
Let me get out in front of you.
Shit. I think he wants to fight.
Code 3-5. Suspicious person on foot. Responding unit investigating. All units, negative visual on suspect. Begin search in immediate vicinity.
How did you fucks miss shit? We missed him.
Go double check, will you?
Get away from here!
Taking cover.
Hey,
don't let me die.
These dumb orphan lads.
I don't deserve to die like me.
Get away from here.
No.
Get right behind us.
So you got your guns?
This ain't fair.
Get him.
Must be the Nigger.
My name is Lincoln Clay, motherfucker.
Nigger? Lincoln Clay? These things mean the same thing.
Capo, that's when he turned his sights on Sal Marcano.
Listen, it's like I said before. It's the same offer ran over in Vietnam. You want to bring down the dipshit in charge? You target their men and infrastructure. Eliminate their ability to fight back. And before they know it, they're standing there all alone, ass hanging out in the wind.
Tired of getting sand kicked in your face?
Gotta do calisthenics 3 times a week. Keep my heart rate up.
You got blood on your shirt.
Cut myself shaving. There's something that you need to hear. Alvarez surfaced. Intercepted this call a little while ago.
I don't understand a word of that. You mind translating?
Basically, you scared the shit out of Alvarez. He's ready to hightail it back to Cuba. Wants his dear Uncle Zaraga to come rescue him.
And what did Zaraga say?
He told him to meet him at the lighthouse on the southern edge of the bayou. He'd send a boat to pick him up.
I'm guessing that was a lie.
Zaraga was a police officer back in Havana when Batista was still running the country. He also provided security for Sal's casinos. The two of them go way back. As soon as Zaraga hung up the phone, he called Sal and told him where he could find his nephew.
Which means I need to get down there before Marcano's men.
Sal's not gonna fuck around when it comes to Alvarez, so make sure your shit's squared away.
I think we got trouble.
Huh?
I find you, you're gonna die slow. Get over here, you bunch of fuckwits.
You understand English? See? I killed the men outside. I only want to talk to you, so I'm gonna put my gun down, all right? If you try and fuck me, I kill you!
Fair enough.
You're the one who wants to kill me!
I wasn't trying to kill you, I was trying to find you. Your uncle, he sold you out. He ain't coming to get you.
You're lying. I just spoke to him. He said he was sending a boat.
Wait, you think it's a coincidence that as soon as you got here, those greaseballs showed up? Zaraga called Marcano, told him where to find you.
I must find a phone.
Jesus, man, there's no one for you to call. Marcano is never gonna let you out of this city. He's gonna use you, and when he gets what he wants, he's gonna kill you. The only shot of getting out of this alive is me.
What do you want from me?
Tell me where Marcano's counterfeit operation is set up and we're square.
Everything is in a boxing ring that Tony Marcano owns, but it's already up and running.
Okay, that's all I need to know. Come on. It's time we got the hell out of here.
Where are you taking me?
I know someone who can get you out of the city. Make sure Marcano doesn't find you.
Yeah.
If you want to live through this, stick close to me. You understand?
I see.
As I walk along, I wonder...
Thank you. That was the last of them, I think.
Yeah, well, keep an eye out anyway.
But you could have killed me, put a bullet in my head, and still fuck my...
You got a question in there somewhere?
Yeah. Why didn't you?
Just didn't sit right. Look, you didn't do anything to me. As far as I can tell, you're just another person in the long line of folks Marcano's fucked over. Sometimes it's as simple as that.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, so...
Megan, what's going on?
I need your help getting this man out of the city. He's in a lot of trouble with Sal Marcano.
I don't...
Hit the lepers. This who you told me about?
Yeah, he's the one. Listen, Father, I'm really counting on you here. I got nowhere else I can take him.
Shit, I'm... All right. I know a Jesuit in New Mexico. He helps people in situations like...
What needs to happen right now? Marcano's gonna tear the city apart and look for him.
All right, I'll make the call. Pasa, por favor. Aquí estás a salvo.
Gracias.
I appreciate this. I handled the last of that problem for you.
Oh. Shit. So it's really fucking over. God damn it.
You all right?
Yeah. It's just, means Joe's really dead. Good friend of mine. It's more like family. Me and him tried to do something big for this motherfucker named Leo Galante. Big shot with the commission. Anyways, it all went south, and we got fucked. That's what you get for following orders, right? It was a couple of years there. I didn't know if Joe was alive or what.
When did you know?
Maybe 4 or 5 years after I got sent down here. I still had a little pull back home. I kept some feelers out. Anyway, word comes back, one of the guys I saw drive off with Joe's running his mouth. Can't hold his liquor. And someone heard him going on about some loudmouth Leo wanted him to put down. Yeah, that same loudmouth cost this guy his front teeth and cracked one of his eye sockets.
Sounds like Joe didn't make it easy for him.
You're goddamn right. Ain't no one taking Joe Barbaro down without a fight. Joe managed to get loose. Was on the run for a while, went to Chicago, thinking a couple of guys up there would help him. Instead, they turned on him. Anyways, in the end, it went how it went. Beat the shit out of him, cut his fucking hands off. Smashed his face all to hell. When it was over, they didn't leave much for anybody to find.
You sure it was Joe?
If it wasn't him. If Joe was still alive, he would have found me by now.
I got Alvarez out of the city.
Good.
He told me you saved his life.
All I did was get him away from Marcano's men.
And thank God for that. Let me ask you something. You ever hear how Sal Marcano wound up running this city?
Him and his brothers killed a few guys and took over.
He sold out his own father, Lincoln. Watched him die. And then he killed every man standing in his way. Butchered them. Them and anyone else he thought was a risk, warranted or not.
How do you know that?
Other priests. The sanctity of the confessional isn't always absolute. I'm not an idiot, Lincoln. You're a criminal. Sammy was a criminal. I accepted that a long time ago, but there's a difference between being a criminal and being a Sal Marcano.
I'm not Sal Marcano.
Easy to say that now, but what about when this is over, when there's no one standing in your way?
I haven't decided yet.
You're a good man, Lincoln. I know it's odd to hear that, considering everything you've done. But it's true. You have it in you. I've seen it. But you're gonna have to decide, have to choose, whether you let all of this consume you, pervert you, turn you into the very thing you hate.
Tommy Marcano brought in a counterfeiter from Cuba, right?
Sal spent a couple of months trying to print the money himself, but none of it was worth a damn. The color was wrong, printing was cockeyed, you name it. He needed someone who knew what the fuck they were doing. So he used his connections and found a man named Alvarez.
And this Alvarez was also counterfeiting money for Castro.
Most of our enemies counterfeit American money. Hell, some of our allies do too.
Sorry, he's gone.
What do you mean he's gone? All you had to do is drive down to the goddamn lighthouse and pick him up.
It's not my fault Alvarez is running all over the goddamn place. I wanted to lock his ass up, but you wouldn't hear of it. The last thing we need is Zaraga finding out that we treated his nephew like dog shit. You understand? Then Lincoln Clay comes in shooting the shit out of everything.
Lincoln Clay. Lincoln Clay. I'm so sick and fucking tired of hearing about this cocksucker. He's just one man. A fucking nigga. We're skating a thin line here, Tommy. You understand? This thing falls apart. We fucked all of us.
So, what the fuck would you do?
What the fuck would I do?
Listen here. This ain't rocket science. If that fucking nigga got to Alvarez, it means he knows about the plate. He's gonna come after him. You understand? Get your ass down to that motherfucking gym and protect them.
Yeah, sure. I'm on it.
This shit ends right here, right now. No more fuck-ups.
Fuck me.
According to these reports, Tommy Marcano had the money press in a boxing gym he operated.
Tommy knew Lincoln was coming for the plates, but he felt he had to keep up appearances. The second he started canceling fights and shutting the place down was the second people started thinking he was out of his league. He wasn't about to allow that to happen.
How did Lincoln Clay gain access to the gym?
He had me track down a man named Alcee Bennett. Alcee is a small-time hustler that worked for Sammy until he double-crossed him and was kicked out of the Hollow. After that, he scratched out a living recruiting fighters for Tommy's jungle fights. If he vouched for Lincoln at the door, Lincoln could get in without a big ruckus.
Well, fuck me running. If it ain't Lincoln Clay.
Surprised to see me, Alcee?
I heard about Sammy and Ellis. Tough break. I guess you made it out okay.
Speak of them once more, and I'll slice you from ear to asshole. Let's go. I'm taking a drive.
Assuming I don't have a choice here.
What do you think?
Lead the way. In the Hollow since November of 62. Almost 6 years. I ain't gonna question your driving, but you might wanna pay attention. What I was saying was, you know I've stayed away. I ain't stepped foot in the Hollow since November of 62. Almost 6 years.
I know.
Can you at least tell me where we're going?
The Acadia. It's where Tommy Marcano holds his jungle fights, right?
It is.
And you've been recruiting black fighters for him.
I have.
Good. Because I want in.
What? Why?
I wanted you to know I'd have told you.
If I'm sticking my ass out like that, I need to know why.
Motherfucker, you lucky to be alive after what you did to Sammy. You really think he wouldn't notice you stealing all that money?
Look, I paid for that 100 times over. 6 years banished from the only place I ever call home. Christ. I couldn't even go see my mama on her deathbed.
You made your choice. And now it's time to make another one.
And I do this.
Get a clean slate. Come and go through the Hollow as you please.
Fuck. Okay.
I hear if you win out, Tommy meets you in person. That true?
He likes to size up the winners. See if there's someone he wants to bring on regular. Or if they're just a one-time deal.
Where's this happen?
Usually up there in his office. One of his guys will meet you in the locker room after the fight. He'll take you to Tommy.
All right. Yo.
Good thing go by me. Ooh, 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 ooh. I had a good riders don't take the front entrance. We go in through the side door.
Hold up, Alcee. Who the fuck's this?
This? This is Jackknife Johnson.
What's he here for?
Fuck you mean, what he here for? We here to fight, boy.
Gotta search him. No weapons allowed.
Do what you gotta do. Watch where you put your hands, motherfucker.
Save it for the ring, dipshit. Go ahead.
Locker room's down here on the end. Hang back, boys.
Motherfucker needs a doctor.
Just dump him in an alley. Let nature take its course.
You good now. Go on.
How you, Neville?
Where you at, Alcee?
All right. I gotta go make the arrangements. Give him your name and such. You go on and get changed.
Who you got with you tonight, Alcee?
New guy.
You guy looks tough. My money's staying on the brawler.
I gotta ask you something, Alcee.
What's that?
Do all you niggas love beating the fuck out of each other?
So what happens if we get caught?
Probably what you think.
For a chance to go home again, it's worth it. No matter what happens, we should go. This is it. You nervous?
Should I be?
Guess that depends on where all this ends. You're gonna head through these doors and they announce your name, then make your way to your corner.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'll meet you there. This part of the show is all about you. They love showing off their fighting niggas.
Through here.
And the jungle fights continue, boys! The next challenger to face Nick Boom Boom Boma comes in at over 6 feet tall. Approximately 220 pounds. This is Jackknife Johnson!
I can't hear you, assholes! Get loud! Yeah, you love this, don't you?
making his way to the ring as the Beast of the Bayou, the Rampage of River Road, your champion, Great Digger Vaughn!
You know why they call him Grave Digger?
Because he buries motherfuckers?
Well, yeah.
So how do I beat him?
You hit him really, really hard.
I won't see blood. Couple goddamn tomato cans we got here. Fucking fight.
We have a new champion, Mr. Jack Knife Johnson!
Let me hear, let me hear.
That's it, kid. Let's go.
What happens now?
You head on back to the locker room and collect your winnings.
Where are you heading?
Me? I got business to attend to.
You niggas really know how to brawl. My respect, that's for fucking sure.
You must think I'm some kind of goddamn moron coming in here like you did.
I've never been one to shy away from a calculated risk.
Maybe you should have. I mix some vegetable oil in it. Makes the gasoline thick, sticky. We're just gonna let it soak in a little bit. Work his way into every nook and cranny. That way when I light it, that shit's gonna burn like napalm.
And you are gonna hurt like no one's hurt before.
Fuck you.
Guess you ready to die.
You still be conscious as the flames creep up your legs. But as they burn, you'll be hit in the gut with a sickening revelation. Before you die, you gonna feel your pecker burn. It's gonna curl and twist.
Gonna bury you!
Fire! Fire in that door!
Dropping like fucking flies!
I'm empty!
Only thing needs working out of your funeral arrangements.
So that's that, then.
Sure looks that way.
You know, Sal wanted me to go to law school. Work for some big company. Maybe run for office. Do something decent with your goddamn life, you understand?
Should've listened to him.
It's in the blood, you know.
Yeah. You are who you are. No point in arguing with yourself about it.
Fuck you.
Let me burn. Please.
Say hello to Lou. Tell him Sal will be along shortly.
No, can't wait
to kill your dumbass.
Spotted him. Come on. Running for cover.
Face to face.
I'm gonna split you wide open.
Hey!
Come get me, boy.
hit him from the other side. Grab some cover.
Plates that Sal Marcano stole from the Federal Reserve.
I don't recall.
Bankin once told me he couldn't tell any other cheat. That the world doesn't work that way. I spent the better part of 40 years trying to prove him wrong. But I was just lying to myself. Look at how we treat each other. Passion is a sign of weakness, but greed is a virtue. The poor is considered morally corrupt while every excess of the powerful is celebrated. We sent kids off to die. For what? So someone can make a few bucks? Lincoln was right. He was always right. There ain't never gonna be another Dr. King or a Bobby Kennedy. But there always gonna be another Sal Marcano, another Sammy Robinson, another Lincoln Clay. We are cruel and wicked people.
No stolen lot. Is this goddamn city finally ours?
There's no one left to stand in our way. We run this city now.
My guys are working the action here just like you asked. I figure you called us in for a reason. I also figure you ought to just keep us there.
You got a plan for this territory, right? That's the only reason I can think of why you wouldn't call me.
Whoever you call to lock down the action is up to you, and I respect that. But now, you're talking long-term responsibility. You trusted me with the last piece of the city. No reason to not trust me with this one as well.
Gonna need Vito to run this turf.
Thanks, kid. Spent most of my life getting fucked by one asshole or another. And what we got going here is a real future. Ain't no one fucking with us anytime soon.
Kinda thought I'd be gator shit by now. So anything shy of that, and I'm good.
Fuck. Fuck. You know how long I've been waiting for someone to stand up and be a man of his word? And in all my fucking days, you, Lincoln Clay, are the first motherfucker to do it. Thank you. You've done a hell of a job, Lincoln. Couldn't have done a better job myself. Probably.
Holy Christ! How the fuck did we make it through this shite in one piece? I thought for a certain Scaletta'd have his throat slit by now. You did a bang-up job here, lad. A goddamn dream come true. Can't wait to see where we go from here.
I halfway figured Lincoln will have killed us all by now. What we done here? Taking the city away from Marcona and doing it without killing each other? We gotta be proud of that. I'll admit it. I had my doubts, but no more. You came through just as you promised, and I'm lucky to be a part of it.
We're living proof that the ways of Marcano, the lying, the backstabbing, the cheating, don't need to run in that direction. Those ways are as dead as he is. Wasting any time, are you?
Your little rampage is going to attract attention. Attention from people I don't care to associate with.
Yeah, imagine not.
Thankfully, closing off your loose ends is as simple as tossing around some super grade. With any luck, this will keep them off my ass. For a little while, anyway. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. There's still the matter of killing Georgie and Sal. You should get a kick out of hearing this.
Georgie, get your ass in here. Your Uncle Tommy's dead. I thought you'd like to know. He was a smart kid, your Uncle Tommy. He could have been anything. I tried to tell him, go to law school. Instead, he went to Cuba.
I'm sorry, Pops. Now, I know what he meant to you.
I am leveraged out the ass, called in every favor, and none of it made a goddamn difference. We're fucked. I am fucked.
Now that's bullshit. We still got some men. I say to we hit the streets and we find that cocksucker.
Every lowlife ball of piss in this city smells blood in the water. My blood. You understand? And they step over their own mother. If it meant being the one that clipped me, I wouldn't last 10 minutes out there.
That's a crock of shit. You are the Sal Marcano. There's gotta be something that we could do.
Come here, boy. Come here. You call up whatever men we still have left. You tell them to meet us up there at the casino. And when Lincoln Clay shows up, we'll do everything we can to put that goddamn nigga in the ground right next to us. Go on now, get the fuck out of here.
Should have known that Marcano would go to ground at the casino.
You can take the bridge up there so it's a straight shot.
You know, none of this would have happened without you.
It's either this or right away in some goddamn office. And once you've killed those assholes, you come and find me. I'll be hanging around over at the Padres.
You got it.
You give them hell, champ.
Thank you.
boy. Get a shot. How about a hand hit?
You and me now.
Downstairs handle this. It's what they're getting paid for. I ain't come here to watch someone else do all the work. I came here to bury that cocksucker, just like we said. Be careful, kid. I ain't the one you need to be worried about.
Targets have gotta go.
Of course. Be there soon.
Vito sent me. Blew that fucking smithereen.
Time to die.
Yeah.
taking cover! Shit! Grenade!
Targets, I gotta go.
Of course, be there soon.
You've made some poor choices in your life.
Motherfucker. I always thought you were my friend. That you had me and Ellis's backs. It was just an act. You didn't kill me because I said no. You killed me because you thought you owned me. Owned all of us.
It was never about us. About my old man. My father. I did anything for him. Same as you and Sammy.
And you understand why I have to do this.
In this world, Lincoln, but you're not, and you never will be.
Hell of a sight, ain't it? When I first come to this town, it was nothing more than a backwater shithole. Now look at it.
Let me see your hands.
Whatever was between us is over, you understand? It ended the second it was you coming up them stairs instead of my son. Want a drink?
All right.
I had this imported from Scotland. Single malt. Now, usually I'm a bourbon man, but I figured I'd order something with a little more class for when the casino opened. Not much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Don't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucho died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. A giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. And there was another one where cotton mouths.
biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was George's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucho's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. All of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the men sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
I would imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
And this was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people, more than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes, here we are. My son is dead, and I'm having a drink with his killer. Now, I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you didn't. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? I knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. There's only one thing we know. One thing we're good at. I'm gonna be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
What are you waiting for? Fucking do it. Finish this, you fucking coward. You just gonna fucking stand there? God forgive me. Bring it!
Take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally a pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here, right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net, cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, oh, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, do you?
No, sir.
Well, in exchange, you run things as you see fit. Wanna sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is the 20%.
And what if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just 'cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Thank
you.
You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California? Leave all this behind? And just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go! And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Fuck.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine
is on the verge of breaking.
Sal and Georgie are gone. And after all the shit we've been through, we run this city.
After all the bullshit, it's almost impossible for me to wrap my brain around the fact that we actually did it. You're a fucking saint, Lincoln. And I'm honored to know you.
No, that's the kind of news you never get tired of hearing.
So we finally gonna get our chance to make things right in this town. Bring a balance to things. Wasn't certain we'd ever actually get here.
We're not here because of what I did, or because of what any of y'all did. We're here because we stood together. And as long as we stay strong, ain't no one ever gonna fuck with us.
After he killed Summer, Connell Lincoln Clay took over. But he wasn't content just to run the city. He expanded out across the South into Florida and even the Carolinas. So much money coming in, and he's been smart with it. He spreads it around, makes sure the right people get paid and stay paid. The city's favorite son, Yeah. Rebuilding the Hollow, buying up Frisco Field, reopening the theme park, all that money and goodwill, he thinks it's made him untouchable, but no one is untouchable. He might have plastered his name across a few schools and hospitals, made donations to a charity here and there, but nothing absolves him of his crimes. That's why I agreed to do this documentary. I want to shine a light on the real Lincoln Clay.
Lincoln gave in to everything. Drugs, booze, prostitutes, you name it. If he made a dollar, he was involved. Seeing him on the news, strutting around. Sometimes I think he should have died over at Sammy's with all the rest of them. That'd be kind of a peace in that.
About any of this.
Let me ask you something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do with...
What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Sit down and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assume you would say that.
Don't fucking move! You're out of your mind.
I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you
them
never
to
get
see
away
that, you stupid asshole, because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you. And they're next. Gentlemen,
God, you're hurt.